Hi there, welcome to Mini Review, and today we're going to review the book Educated by Tara Westover. Oh god, this book made me realize so many things. All the books make me realize so many things, you know, but this is a book which made me familiar with so many things. When I was a child, my parents have definitely pampered me, and every time I get a small, some fever or everything, they used to take care of me. When I had my children, I used to pamper them. When they fall sick, I get really worried, give them all the antibiotics and all the tablets. But this book makes us made me realize that there's a completely different way of bringing up children. And I don't know whether it's right or wrong. And I'm in no way to judge my parents, of course. And I'm sure many of you have been brought up in the same culture where we take care of our kids. We give them all the love, all the affection, and every time they fall down, you run and pick them up. But are we doing the right thing? These are the questions which each one of us have to ask. Because today's children, they I don't know what happens to them, you know. They can't take in criticism. They can't concentrate. They can't focus. They want fast, fast results, you know. So why does all this happen? As I was reading this novel, which is a memoir of Tara Westover, I actually began to realize that maybe it is the parents, we, who are to be blamed for whatever has been happening to our children. Tara Westover comes from Idaho. I don't know how to, I think I'm pronouncing it right. She comes from that the mountainous region of America, and she loves the mountains, and they are they have seven siblings. Her father is paranoid about the government. So what he does is, as when the children were born, they don't have a birth certificate. They have all been born at home. They have not been given any inoculation, and they don't go to school. Why? Because he doesn't want the interference of the government. He feels that the government comes, they will take over his family. So he has an armload of ammunitions in his house. He's always ready with a lot of food, all canned foods. During the summer, he makes his wife have all canned peach jam, pickles, and all those things. And meat is dried and packed and ready. So he is a paranoid. Which Tara later realizes, actually her father had a bipolar disorder. And this is what made him paranoid. Now, Tara, till the age of 16, she has never left Idaho. And she lives with her family. And her father has a junkyard. So he makes all the children work in the junkyard. So as the children reach the age of 12 to 13, they slowly start leaving her, because her father is her father's style of bringing up the children is completely dictatorial. Once what happens is, one of her brothers, Luke, I told you they have a junkyard, and they crush the cars. And after crushing the cars, what the father does, he has a machine, and he has to take out the gasoline from all the cars. Only then he has to crush the engine. So when he's crushing it, he has a machine for that. So what happens is, even this boy, this 10 or 12 year old Luke also does that. And some gasoline spills on his dress. And when they are crushing the thing, they have a sort of a flame sort of a thing. And when Luke is doing it, he didn't realize that his jeans had petrol. And his dress catches on fire. His father is not able to do anything, because he's one of the cranes or something where he's doing it. So this boy is burning, he doesn't know what to do, and as he's running over, the flame is it's gushing up to his part of the body. He runs into the fields, and what happens is the whole fields is burning now. And their house is very close by, so Tara is there. When Tara comes out of the kitchen, Tara is supposed to do cooking, supposed to clean the house. Her mother does some, she makes some herbs, some medicines, and also she helps her mother, she helps her father. I don't know whether you call it child labor, but she does all the work in the house. So as Tara is in the kitchen, she suddenly hears some sound. She runs out and she sees her brother literally burning, you know. So she runs, she takes a rug, wraps it around him, and she doesn't know what to do. She doesn't know whether she has to pour water. Oh my God. Can you imagine the thing which this 10-year-old girl has to go through? This is just one of the things which happens. Another time what happens is, sometimes, you know, during summer, the whole family goes on a road trip to Arizona. They have an old dilapidated van, And what happens is, as the father drives, all the children are driving. The eldest is around 17 or something. The eldest has already left the house. So the youngest is around 14, 15 years. He's the one who's driving the vehicle. So they drive through the night. And I think he falls asleep. Richard, one of the siblings of Tara. And he hits a pole. And an electric pole. And they're all sleeping. It's all the night. So they're all sleeping in the van. Somehow the father gets out and he tells, when they all wake up, they're all feeling pain in the neck and hand, but they don't know what has happened. So the van has tilted and the father tells all of them, don't touch the van because an electric pole is running, it is a charged wire is running. And suddenly he looks at his wife. His wife's head is it's cut, it's bleeding, nose is bleeding, eyes are all red, black and all things. But he says, don't worry. Somebody will come and help us. God is there. He'll definitely help us. I don't know how, but maybe some neighbor heard about it and they called the ambulance. The ambulance comes. They got the electricity is cut. And they find the mother doesn't know what is happening. Because I guess she must be having a concussion. So the next few days, months, she has raccoon eyes. You know, she's all these black eyes. She's not able to remember. She doesn't know who her children are. She keeps telling them, who are you? So in spite of all this, they don't take her to the doctor because the father believes God will save them. This family believes in the Mormon religion, which is a sect of Christianity, but they are very ardent. I've never heard of the Mormon religion, but what I understood from this is they don't believe in medicine. They don't take any medicine. Their sole belief is in the Lord. So they hope the Lord will come and make everything all right. Now, as Tara grows up in this atmosphere, where she's supposed to be homeschooled, but her father doesn't have allow her to do it because she has to work, she has to do all the works, so there's no time for homeschooling. But somehow she sits for an exam which she takes to go to the high school. She clears the exam and goes on to the high school, and there she feels very odd, you know, because she knows she's far other people. When she sits in class, she doesn't know about the maths they're teaching her. She's never even heard about Holocaust. She's not heard about civil rights. So, and remember, this is a child who's one of her brothers, Sean, used to keep calling her nigger. And she never knew what this word meant, you know. So, and it is later on, as she goes through school, around the age of 17, 18, that she realizes that she was actually being abused by her brother. So then she has a fight. She confronts the family. The family disagrees to believe her. She's cast away from the. A lot of things happen. It is a very beautiful novel. So, it's a novel about triumph. It's a novel about struggle for your existence. It's a novel where a girl stands up for herself for what she believes, and a person who's never gone to a formal school goes on to Cambridge University. So it's a very beautiful novel by Tara Westover. You should read this novel. It is you actually come to realize that you're so blessed. So do drop in your comments and do check out the description section for the link. And thank you so much.